In this tutorial, we'll be showing you how to repair models for 3D printing using Netfabb Basic. Once you have Netfabb open, you should go to Project, and Add Part. You can see here a list of all the different file formats available for import into Netfabb. You have your standard 3D formats like PLYs, OBJs, as well as some program-specific files. If you're having trouble exporting an STL file for 3D printing from whichever 3D program you're working in, you can always export as one of these file formats and convert it using Netfabb. Once your file loads in Netfabb, if you see this exclamation point in the bottom right corner of your screen, that means there are errors in your model, and the file will most likely not 3D print correctly. As you look at your file, you'll see that the errors are highlighted in red. Taking a closer look at this model, you can see that this is a hole caused by bad or improperly connected edges, meaning that this main body is no longer watertight. The red geometry on the hand indicates that there are inverted normals, or as Netfabb refers to them, flipped triangles. Essentially, the geometry is inside out. You see here the top face of the raised R is also inverted. And you can see here the top face of the P is missing completely, causing a non-watertight surface. In case your errors aren't immediately clear to you by looking at your model, Netfabb provides the model analysis mode. Select Extras, New Analysis, Standard Analysis, and you enter Analysis View. On the right-hand side of the screen, you'll see some information, including whether or not the surface is closed or watertight. It'll also give you information about the number of bad edges, holes, and flip triangles that exist in your model. It will give you some volume information if you want to begin to estimate the cost of your print, and it will also give you some size information. To begin to repair your models, go to Extra, Repair Part, and you'll enter Repair View. As you can see, your model is now blue, but the problem areas are still highlighted in red, and now the problem edges are highlighted in yellow. For simple, more obvious errors, Netfabb provides you with manual repair tools. I'm going to select based on shells, and select the hand. And I'm going to go to this icon and select Flip Selected Triangles. I'm going to do the same for the foot. Flip Selected Triangles. And now these two large problem areas are fixed. For more complex problems, Netfabb has an automated repair mode. Select Automatic Repair. Select Default Repair and click Execute. When you're ready, click Apply Repair, and you can choose to either remove your old part and replace it with a repaired part, or keep your old part and apply the repairs to a duplicate. Looking at the file now, you can see this hole is fixed, and now this main body is watertight. However, zooming in on this P, you can see these missing faces were repaired incorrectly. Basically, the error was too complex for the automated fix. The original design has been altered, and some errors may still remain. For more complex errors such as this, we recommend going back to the original 3D program you used to create the file, and attempting to repair the files from there. When you're satisfied with the repairs that you've done, you should export the file as an STL. You can go to Part, Export Part, and select STL. FIT's FabLab only accepts STLs for 3D printing. As you can see, the name has already been appended to indicate that it has been repaired. Chances are you will not have to optimize your file further, so you can go ahead and just click Export. For more information about the FabLab, please visit fitnyc.edu/printfx. And to obtain a free copy of Netfabb Basic, go to netfabb.com.